We're here, the championship game of season 5 of the CeleNation League. I'm your play-by-play analyst, Joshua Gonzalez, and I'm here with Coach Tone.
Coach Tone.
Yup, it's the championship game. The Dogs, sponsored by Ashes Bakeshop, are taking on the Makos, sponsored by Amat Law. This is going to be a really good game. A lot of people anticipated that this would be the matchup for the championship game. What's your thoughts?
I think it's going to be a really solid game. Both teams are kind of like built the same, like athletes all around and one or two bigs and a smart point guard on each side. I think this game's going to be determined on Yusef's composure. If Yusef stays composed, the Bakers can possibly win, or it's going to be a close game. But if he's not composed, then I just don't think it's going to be that close. I think the Dogs will win it.
Imagine the Dogs winning for the fourth time? That would be insane.
That's
be on like a bowl
historical.
Room.
That's like the Celtics back in the 60s with Bill Russell. Luke didn't play a single minute against me, but he starts against the Dogs. Interesting game plan.
That's their game plan.
Freaking Luke.
They came prepared.
I wish he played. I like Luke.
Running into each other, almost kissing each other.
Well,
Shot Doc had a good game coming in here.
Kyle is definitely their X factor. He is the smartest player on the court by far. It's not even close.
IQ wise, yep.
Yes.
Chef passing it out to Montel. Can't hit a three.
Makos are home, Dogs are guests. My bad, had to handle the scoreboard.
Yeah, you're good. That's why we switched seats so you can help.
Yeah, I gotta help out Nick Arancini. Reaper legend. La Familia ex team member. I love Nick. Nick's my guy.
Oh, by the way, great ref.
Sometimes. This is a good matchup right here. Montel on 1v1. Actually, we have good matchups all over the court. We got Yusef on Chef.
Yeah.
We got 1v1 on Montel. Luke on Mike. I mean, we got it all over. So
Mike caused a quick little scramble right there.
Yeah.
Almost forced a turnover.
You got to watch out. They like pressing and pushing the pace. And the Makos like to slow it down, run their offense, do their high IQ players, and let Yusef just do Yusef stuff.
Well, Yusef was getting a little bit aggravated the way Mike shot. Parker was playing. That's a nice shot right there from Shot Dog.
He's been hitting today.
Mike Parker was playing suffocating defense on Yusef, and he was getting upset. So I feel like the Dogs are going to do the same thing. Cause pressure on him.
I don't think, other than Chef, there's anyone on that team that can do what Mike Parker does. I think
probably
Chef
Mike
is the closest one. Mike can, but he's not as athletic as Mike Parker. I think Chef is the closest to it. Oh, quick timeout. Also, the little side story right here. Now, I know we had the three-point contest, and I've done this before in the past. The last game to the championship, I'm telling you, it's tough. Like, you don't think it's like you think it's a long break and you don't feel it, but you're going to feel the fatigue coming into this game.
Oh, yeah.
And I think that's going to be a big difference. The first game to me is just a huge advantage.
Yeah.
Because you got a game break, you got the 3-point contest, you got everybody making sure everything is set up. So the second game, I'm telling you, I did that last season. It's tough.
The Dogs are literally coming off a game they just won that they had to put effort to win. And the Makos had a little break in between, so we'll see.
They had a hour break with the 3-point contest to this game, so they could eat, get bodies rested, hydrate, do their things. And the Dogs, they didn't have that opportunity, so I'm very interested to see. The first half, I think it was going to be really close, but the second half is going to make the whole game.
Yeah, that's where we're going to see who's going to win and take home this beautiful trophy.
Yeah, I don't want to touch it because it's bad juju.
I can touch
it because you're not playing. But I'm not touching that thing.
I
touched it last
season.
I feel like that's why I didn't win. But I feel like I won today. Now, next season, I might win. Big shot by Mike.
Oh, and he hits it. You know,
Mike has improved so much from the back end.
He was like timid to shoot it. He was hesitating to shoot the ball. And now he's just confident when he pulls from the 3-point line. And I think that's been a really real plus for the Dogs second half of the season. Yeah,
the back end of the season has been huge for Mike. Because he did struggle a little bit early and not making and like thinking over things a little bit too much. But when he was like, I'm just gonna play basketball. And that's when he decided to, that's when he was in rhythm, making his layups, making his threes, and everything he needs to do to help the Dogs. So I feel like Mike is the most important player captain on the in the league.
Oh yeah.
Like I'm more important like X's and O's, but Mike's important playing.
Right. Spain doesn't hit from the corner. Oh, Mike gets the ball. See? Right back to Donnie. Oh, that's the assist of the day brought to you by We Buy Houses. Oh, my goodness. That's a 2K play right there.
See, that's what I'm talking about. Mike's just important. And, Chef, I told another thing I called.
Ashley making sure the gear is safe.
Ash is making sure the workshop is safe. She got the bake shop and the
cookies. You know what? Let's bring this cookies back a little bit more.
We got cookies? Yo, let me get a cookie.
Man, that's why I use that excuse to bring it closer. Can I get a cookie?
Dang it. I haven't had a cookie since
last
season.
That's my fault, though. I haven't had a cookie yet. I'm pretty sure they're amazing.
Yeah, let's do an advertisement. Because I'm very good at those.
Oh yeah.
Of Ash's Bake Shop. Actually, Ash
is a meticulous baker.
What's the theme for this month?
My anniversary, so it's all like anniversary stuff.
Anniversary stuff.
Yeah, it's my 3-year anniversary.
Well, congratulations to Ash and Mike, but also congratulations to everybody in the world having these cookies.
Oh yeah.
Great take by Chef. Him and Yusef are the only like pros on the court, and it shows. Their IQ is very high.
Here comes Amakos. 1v1 guy down the lane. Gets it in. That's a sweet finish of the day. Brought to you by Ash's Bake Shop.
Yep. Nice. I just love Yusef's energy, man.
Yeah.
It's infectious to the whole team.
It's great.
Let's see here, Chef.
When he starts screaming and slamming the floor, you know he's about to take off.
But the funniest thing to me is when he starts praying.
Yeah. When they're doing the free throws?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's hands great. On the knees, you know. Oh, it's that's a big shot right here again. Too. Oh. Got to get back.
I'm not mad about that.
I'm not mad either. But the
Makos. Oh, wow.
The Makos got to get back because, like, that's the Dog's thing. They, like, push, making you take long transition threes, and then they force turnovers, and they push in transition.
Dogs are really good at getting their own rebounds and putting it back in, converting points. Yeah, Montel just coming in, cleaning up what Donnie couldn't, you know, finish in the...
The Dogs trade made them one of the more athletic teams in the whole league.
Oh, yeah.
Because now they got Spank. They got Spank and Montel. See, there it is, the energy.
That's the Super Saiyan I was saying 2 games ago.
Yeah, Yusef won a ring with Mike season 3, so he's been in this place before. He's won in this stage before, so that definitely helps out the Makos.
What the fuck does that mean? I gave a team foul.
Nick.
Oh, behind the back.
Oh, wow.
Oh, couldn't make it in. That is brick of the day brought to you by Zane the Realtor. You got to finish the play. That would have been dish. That would have been sweet finish. That would have been everything. That would have been assist.
Steal.
Shoot, you know what? That would have been highlight of the day. That would have been on the Instagram page, the TikTok page.
The YouTube short.
Everything. In my opinion, other than Eric, Sauce and Braylon are the two best officials in this league, which also helps. Yeah, no, Eric's terrible. I love Eric, but he's like, I don't know if you know the NBA, he's like Joey Crawford. He doesn't care about officiating right, he just wants to be in the show.
I think Ryan's
a solid ref. Yeah.
Oh, scramble for the ball. Mako's come up with it, it seems. Give Ryan it to Barry. Ryan Barry.
Oh, turn, that's a travel.
They didn't call it. Mako's get the ball back.
Yeah, you need to slow down right here. You don't got advantage right here. Look top. There you go. Yeah, they need to run some offense. They need to slow down.
JPP taking it in.
No.
Gibson. Ah. Oh.
That was Quinn. That was QDZ. Like, what they did well against us is they slowed us down, ran their offense, moved, passed, screened away, did all this stuff, and they're going away from what worked well. They're right now doing one pass shots, and that's not going to be in their favor in this game, because that's what the Dogs want. The Dogs want to speed you up, turn the ball over, make you take quick shots so they can go in transition.
Yeah, they're trying to keep it at a high pace.
See, they did the same thing again.
Yeah.
And look, they're in transition again.
Yep. Oh, couldn't make it. Spank gets the rebound and puts it in.
Yeah, that's underrated about Spank is he's a great offensive rebound. See another one.
Oh, he makes a deep three. The bank is open.
Lucky play of the day brought to you by CeleNation Basketball.
And that ties the game up. Luck or not, I feel like you should think that Yusef is going to pull those.
Oh, yeah, 100%. Yusef's going to do Yusef things. You know, Yusef's going to pull from half court, pray to the heavens that goes in. And if it goes in, he's going to act like, oh, it should have went in the entire time. And then if he misses, he's just going to complain that it didn't go in. That's Yusef, though. It's just his energy.
And then if you're on the other side of the ball, it's like, damn. Yeah. If it goes in, and damn if it doesn't. You know,
like, damn, he shot that, and damn,
it's a double-edged sword at that point. It's 50-50. If it goes in, it hurts.
Yeah, I'm telling you, Sauce, and Sauce is a great official, so he's going to make sure. He's. I just signed the game.
Yusuf's game is incredible.
Good take.
Oh, wow, that was a good JPP's take.
JPP's draft stock is going to go very high because he does the right things and he plays so well. But that's another big shot by Pat.
Pat Klein.
Pat, broken hand and all, still playing out here. What a legend. The real question is he drunk today? He definitely gambled today, though.
Good take by QD. Yeah, it's starting to become a really great game to watch.
Oh, both they're going into a zone. Yep.
Oh, turnover by the Dogs. Yusef takes a step back three. Praise to the heavens. Oh, in and out.
It teased him. It didn't want to go in there for him. Dang, Yusef.
The CeleNation League gods were not in his favor there.
Yeah, he has to pray to the heavens again. Oh, backwards defense. What a guy.
That is insane. Montel taking it up. Doesn't get the scoop. Yusef going in.
That's what you don't want Yusef to do.
That yeah, he's
is
so good at
the
that.
Best thing of his game
all
right here.
Season. That's all like, season. He's so good at slowing down and changing the tempo.
I don't like that because he put his hands up right down here. And they said that was a no call down there. And then he did the same exact thing on this end. And they called. Like, it's frustrating because you want consistency on both ends of the floor. I understand. You got to call what you got to call. But
Donnie misses the first one.
But I guess Yusef prayed to the heavens and it missed for him.
But yeah, you don't want Yusef going into the paint, slowing down on that Euro step. It really throws everybody off. Hard to time.
It's the best thing of Yusef's game is when he's in the paint around like multiple bodies, he knows how to contort himself to the right spot so he can make an easier layup. It's crazy.
Right? He's falling every move, but it's because he's changing every angle. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
So he knows how to use his angles very well.
And that's just a tough way to play basketball. You're going to eat the floor every time, but Yusef gets back up and keeps chugging along.
Great take.
Oh, 1v1 God.
He's very talented as well. I think he's been underrated this season by Yusef's talent, but the thing that's crazy to me is he adapted his game to fit Yusef's game this whole season.
Oh, yeah. Chef going in. Can't hit, but Montel's there to clean it up, but can't.
He missed too. Look Yusef again, same thing.
Taking it in. It's just, he can't hit that time.
He hustled, though.
And he gets the foul.
the emotions, man. I mean, it's a championship game. You got to put your whole heart and soul into this game if you want to beat the Dogs. Because Mike is going to go at you the whole game. He doesn't care.
Well, like I said about you, because you and Mike are kind of similar in some ways. The way he coaches, he'll analyze the data that he's taken in the first half, and he implements it into the second half. You know what I'm saying?
So yeah.
That could be it right now. He could be taking all this information.
Sorry about that.
The thing, too, with Mike is he knows every player individually. Exactly. So he knows their strengths and weaknesses.
And it all starts from the draft.
Yeah. So he knows what teams, in a way, works well together. I say this season is the one time he kind of made a couple mistakes in the draft early, but he made it up late drafting G, drafting Ryan, trading for Montel. Mm-hmm. So he made up for the fact that he knows he made a couple mistakes, but he did make up for it, and that's why he's here.
Analyzing the data. Seeing what works and what doesn't.
We had 14 minutes go by. Mako's up 5.
Take Yusuf out of the game.
I think he's in foul trouble. I think he has 2 fouls.
He might be, yeah, he might have because they have 3.
He might have 3?
No, they have 3, but you're right. They might have 2.
Yeah, I think Yusuf has 2 of those 3. You need that rebound. You're in the 2-3 zone. Can't hit. That's the weakness of a 2-3 zone is offensive rebounding. Because if it's a long rebound, you're kind of done because you got 3 guys in the paint.
Yeah.
Also, the thing that we're not discussing is we're matching polos with championship games. Only right.
Yep, you're right. Only right. Black on black. Mako's trying to make a play here.
I think this is smart for them, slowing the game down because Yusuf's not in the game right now and looking for the best shot possible. Oh, that's a good pass by JPP.
Oh, 1v1 guy tries to finish there.
Yeah, there's a lot of contact in there. Oh, he's going up 100%.
Donnie going in and makes it. Slowly chipping away at the lead.
Yeah, the non-Yusuf minutes is hurting them right now. They need to slow down.
Yeah, that's exactly. As soon as you said that, Yusuf called it out.
They need to literally slow down, take your time. Like, wait till Yusuf to come back because you have the lead right now.
And the Dogs are trying to take advantage of that.
Big shot right here.
Makes it in. Is that a 3 or is that a 2?
That was a solid 3 right there by 1v1. Ah, you can't lead that. Kyle, great job walling up right there and getting the rebound. X. Big shot again.
The Makos are starting to feel it here.
Another timeout by Mike. Another one.
4 minutes left.
Yeah, if you're the Dogs, you got to take advantage of the Yusuf less minutes because he is pretty much their guy.
Oh, yeah.
You want the timeout read?
Oh, yeah, you're right. Thank you for reminding me. We buy houses and mobile homes, any type, any condition, no equity, no problem. We work fast, use cash, and there's no nonsense. And there's up to $1,000 if you refer a home that goes to closing. So just speak to Josiah Kinn and give him a call at 407-735-6228.
Yeah, it's a championship game, man. They need all the advertisements for this game. So we need the sponsorships. We need them to come back to help out the league, especially next season. We need even more, honestly, next season with everything Mike has planned out to do. I only heard a snippet, like a 10% of his plans, but in that 10% from what I heard, we need everybody to help out, for real. Like, do the little things. Do camera, do stats, do scoreboards, like, do everything. Because it goes a long way, especially if you want to stay in this league. Just got to do that little PSA of what players should be doing real quick.
I'm trying to get some students from Full Sail to come over here and staff everything, the cameras, all that. The players won't have to.
It would help, especially for them. Don't they need, like, community service or, like, hours of doing what they're doing? Or is it just
they're called, like, IL hours, you know. They got to get some time in the field, and this would be a perfect thing for them to do. It's not a lot of pressure. That's a nice
big shot by Money Mitch.
Yeah.
He definitely gambled some money today, so he needs to make these threes to come back with that little money he's going to lose today.
I'm here. Yusuf. shot, Doc. Passes to X. X.
Another three!
Oh, man! The Makos are really starting to let it fly.
What's going on?
So what's going on? Are they talking about tech?
I think Yusef was out of bounds, and he can't be out of bounds. He got to be in bounds when the shot goes in.
I see.
And I think that's what the tech is on.
Chef makes it.
I also think Yusef's been talking a little bit too much. He needs to calm down a little bit. It's going to hurt this team. They need him in the game. He is one of the catalysts of this team. He is the reason why they're here. So he needs to, again. He made the free throw, by the way. You're good. I'm working two shifts right now. No, you're not, Nick. You're doing a fantastic job.
Donnie goes up and gets the and one.
That's the weakness of the zone. If you put the ball in the middle of the floor and you have a good guy that can attack the basket, it should be a layup every single time. Donnie did a great job flashing to the middle of the floor and attacking right when he catches the ball. He does a really good job with that.
Really hard to defend as well.
He's a solid player, you know. That's all I have to say.
Couldn't make that. It's a 6-point game. Makers in the lead. Fadi passes the 1v1 that makes a fadeaway shot.
That's a layup to him, honestly. That's a layup. He practices and makes that shot every day. Oh, we got the hood superstar in the building.
Spank. Oh, makes a three.
Big shot. He doesn't make that many of those, so that's a big shot for the Dogs. If he makes those, that changes their whole game plan.
Oh, yeah. Shot Dog looking for Yusef. Yusef fires deep three,
wow,
and he hits.
Right back. Yeah. Yeah, they're back in the... Oh, they're a man now. Okay. Yep, you need
Spank
to get that
goes
board.
Up. Can't hit.
Good rebound by Fadi.
Oh, that's the assist of the day brought to you by We Buy Houses.
We can also say sweet finish of the day brought to you by Ash's Bake Shop. By the way, he finished around the rim with AJ right there next to him.
That's insane. It was a pass between the legs.
Yeah, you said, I'm telling you. Like, he has all these antics, but his energy is just so infectious, and it helps the team out so much.
And then the passing, people overlook his passing. He has really good passing.
I think one game or somebody, you, me, somebody else, I forgot who it was, said one of his best parts of his game is his passing ability, but he doesn't showcase as much as he should. And this game is showing it.
Yeah, I think that was with me. Because I've been an advocate for this whole season. I'm like, when he passes the ball, it's
he's
dangerous.
He's a scary player, man.
Yeah. And as we said, that turnover, but.
Way to, Kyle, great.
Gets an and one. Sweet finish of the day brought to you by Ash's Big Shot. Wow.
Yeah, big shot, especially with last 20 seconds of the game, the half right here, I mean. It's a big shot.
These two teams came to play, came to conquer.
They came, they saw it, and they conquered, but no one's conquered anything yet for this golden ball of justice.
Yeah, they're trying.
Also, between the captains, I'm going to say this here because it's going to be post-game anyways. The captain that wins gets to choose where we're eating today. So that's one of the reasons I don't want Mike to win because I'm tired of eating at CC's, but... Mike always picks CC's. We had Olive Garden last year, and I love Olive Garden, but he said CC's this year. I don't want to go back there.
Oh, wow.
Well, I mean, we got the extra 3 seconds, but It didn't do anything. Couldn't do anything with it. It's okay.
And with that, we're going to be going to our sponsors for the halftime.
Whether we're shipping across the country to your home or delivering to your Walt Disney World Resort, Ash's Bake Shop is here to help with all of your cookie cravings. With over 100 million views across all platforms, Ash's Bake Shop's viral jumbo cookies have taken the world on by storm. Each cookie is hand-topped and comes in a variety of unique flavors that rotate each month. Along with cookies, we also offer brownies, blondies, and cookie cakes to help you celebrate any occasion. You can find us on all social media platforms at Ash's Bake Shop or head over to our website, ashesbakeshop.com. To learn how we can add a little extra sweetness to your day.
This is attorney Rochelle Amat with Amat Law. I'm a Florida personal injury attorney specializing in auto accidents and slip and falls. I have years of experience recovering millions for my clients at one of the nation's top law firms. If you or a loved one find yourself in this unfortunate situation, make sure to call us today. It would be our honor to represent you. We're super excited to be part of CeleNation this season. Let's go Makos.
All right, and we're back. The championship game. 44-33, Dogs are down.
Down 11.
Yep. They have a big mountain to climb.
It was a great end of half for the Makos. They ended on a very high note, and that is why this deficit is the way it is.
What do you think the Dogs are going to change or going
to going to adjust how to beat a zone, because they did it a couple times very well, but they went away from it, and it got them a couple turnovers, and that's what got them in the end of the half. Easy layups, easy threes for Yusuf. 1v1 being in rhythm. They got to get 1v1 and Yusuf out of rhythm for them to have an opportunity. Like right there.
Yep.
That's perfect.
Yep. Calls a foul. Yep.
That's what you want. You want to go from the wings and attack the inside. They got X in the middle, so I mean, X has no choice but to foul.
That's true. Especially when they're coming in like that, especially like someone like Donnie, yeah.
AJ's very good and very crafty around the rim with his left hand. He just got to make some free throws. What's costing him right now, he's missing a good amount of free throws.
Yep. Steve the Kid called him Jack Sparrow, so I guess.
Jack Sparrow. He does look like a pirate. I ain't going to lie to you. I don't think about Captain Jack Sparrow, but he would be on the Black Pearl.
On the Black Pearl, yeah.
He would be on the Black Pearl. Maybe the Flying Dutchman. He will be cursed. He will be cursed for eternity to Davy Jones.
I love Pirates of the Caribbean.
It's such a good series. I'm glad it's coming back. I'm glad Johnny Depp is reprising his role of Captain Jack Sparrow.
It's iconic.
It's very iconic. It's kind of like Arnold Schwarzenegger in The Terminator. Yeah, you just can't replace certain roles. It's like Chadwick Boseman, R.I.P. with Black Panther.
Oh, dude.
It's like
don't make me cry on here, bro.
Like Tony Stark is RDJ. It's like kind of guys that you just can't replace out there.
Yeah.
Like with the Makos or Yusuf. You can't replace Yusuf on the Makos.
You can't. Donnie.
They're back in the 2-3.
Yep. Chef. Takes it in.
Great take.
Woo! Sweet that finish is, of the day. Brought to you by Ash's Bait Shop.
That is a professional take right there.
That's so nice.
Head down, going to his dominant hand.
Yeah, at that point, he's like, if they hit me, they hit me. I'm going up with it. Same thing could be said by 1v1 guy.
Underrated thing about that play is Q took out his defender out the play. Oh, Yusuf again.
Oh, Mike gets it back.
So two turnovers in a row.
Back-to-back turnovers, yep.
By two champions. Mike floated in the lane, can't hit. You need to get that board. Omar's hustling out here, though.
He really is.
Oh, good defense by Yusuf. Great effort. Still an 11-point lead for the Makos. Dogs need to, like, cut this with, like, 10 minutes left to, like, 6, in my opinion, for them to have a chance.
Yeah.
They need to cut this to 6. And that's
that
how
helps.
It starts.
And that helps. No, you're right. Yeah. They could cut it down to 6. You do the math. We have enough time to...
Because
come all the way back, actually. Get a lead, even.
Right back.
Oh, they can't let that happen.
Right back.
Though. They can't let that happen, though.
That's what I'm saying. That's the scary thing about the Makos is they have the firepower to maintain leads because almost anybody on the floor can make a play at certain times. And that is why they're here. And that's why they beat me.
Yeah, so many weapons to worry about. Mm-hmm. You know, it's hard to stay on all of them.
Yeah, because you have Quentin that's able to rebound and make plays on the on the glass. You got Kyle spreading the floor out. X can do that too, and also hustle for the offensive glass. Like, their whole team has certain
Gibson
roles.
Gibson can do anything from 3-point shot to the mid range. Yeah.
So the whole team, 1 through 9, they have a certain role and they kind of perfected it. And they bought in and they're just playing together. And that's on Luke, honestly. Like, Luke manages these guys and help them get to the right place at the right time.
Montel's good on the first.
Good big shot. Second.
One v one, God.
That's a scary pass. I don't like those lollipop passes.
No. Especially with a team like the Dogs, they'll crash in on you.
Big shot right here. Oh, good rebound by Yusuf. Oh my goodness,
he got up there. Couldn't hit. Spank with the rebound. Oh yeah,
Yusuf soared to the heavens that he prayed to right there for that rebound. Like, oh my goodness.
AJ,
great take.
Goes up, gets it in. Brings
great
it
take.
Down to 7.
Great defense by Chef, I'm telling you.
8-second violation. Good defense by the Dogs. This could be the turning point, like you said.
They got 5 more minutes to bring this under 6. Yeah,
it's looking good so far.
I think with this half full court press that the Dogs are doing, I would say you need to put Kyle in the game because he's just so high IQ. That's a charge right there. Yep, good call by Sauce. I think you need to put Kyle in the game because you need high IQ players for a press. Kyle would be the guy to flash middle and make it easier for his guards. Oh, we need the mop. Where is Nick when you need him? They told him, didn't run the clock.
A lot of confusion with the clock.
I think the ref said to stop it, but the rule is to run it. We've been doing it all season with mops and everything. It's like when there's a dead ball, we're still running it to the last 2 minutes. Unfortunately, we got a time limit in this gym, so we should
get some mop boys, you know, like when they're over here, and mop it down.
That is the next, I'm telling you, next league.
Little by little.
Oh, good board by X. Big shot right here. Oh,
can't
big
hit.
Board by JPP.
Oh, doesn't see Chef.
Good hustle by JPP again. Great call by Kyle. That is why Kyle is so important on this team. He's so high IQ. He coaches basketball on the side. He played high level. He played college basketball. Like, he knows how to do this stuff.
How are you?
Chilling, man.
It's great to see you.
It's great to see you guys.
Season 5. Coming to a close.
I wish it was over.
Well, in 14 minutes and 23 seconds, you'll have your wish.
I can't fucking wait. God damn it.
Here we go. God damn it. I fucking love Sauce. All right, we're back.
And with that, we got one hop to shop. It's the official home of all CeleNation merchandise. The first drop of the CeleNation Season 5 merch. It's hoodies, t-shirts, long sleeves. Contact at CeleNation League on Instagram to place your order. The gear is really nice. Mm-hmm. I see you with the long sleeve. I think I saw Franchise with the hoodie a couple podcasts ago.
Yeah.
They're really good. I mean, if Mike did design them, he did a really good job because they're really cool.
I need to get me
cool.
One of your guys' jerseys, but I like
the alternates.
Yeah, the alternates.
If
are
we
fire,
won,
yeah.
I was gonna take them out this game.
The alternates are
if
fire.
We did win, but unfortunately, the alternates gonna have to wait till next season.
Yeah, no, the alternates are pretty dope. Oh! Looked like he wanted to dunk that.
No, that's how he finishes his layups. He,
really?
He drops his shoulder to the defender. That's very smart of him, too, because he can't really get
Montel
blocked.
Montel was right in the paint.
They didn't see him. X is right there in the right place.
AJ takes a 3, and they let him.
That's what you want him to do. Yeah. And 1.
Oh, that was a good move by 1v1 God.
Yeah, we need, like I said, it's still a 9-point lead. They need to bring this down to 6 in the next 3 minutes if they want to have a shot.
That's true. Montel doing what he does. Sweet finish of the day brought to you by Ashes Bake Shop.
You just can't teach athleticism, and that's what that man is.
Oh, no, yeah. You have it or you don't.
He is a freak of nature. And 1.
And he gets an and 1.
Yeah.
Oh, they call it on the floor, actually.
Is it on the floor? Braylon.
51-44 on the floor.
It was on the floor.
I think he was going up, but I think they called it before he went up. And that is why this rule is so confusing. Because you never know what is the stoppage when he does it not going up. I think we just need to play continuation.
Mike has been talking about that, stating he would like that.
Because it's more confusing on the officials and the players.
Nice. That's good a finish. Sweet finish. Brought to you by Ash's Bake Shop once again.
Yeah. We need the cookies.
I mean, hey, the... Come on, Charlie.
Why didn't we do an advertisement? Also, the halftime show was Chris Scalco, by the way. Unfortunately for you guys, I think in the broadcast, you're not going to see the halftime show, but he did a really good job. Big shot right here.
Oh. That's right. Keep taking those.
Oh, no.
Yusuf is going to take a deep three.
You don't need that.
Can't hit.
It's a five-point game. You don't need that, Yusuf. That's a terrible shot.
Ash is saying we do need that.
Well, Ash wants that.
Oh, yeah.
If you're a dog, you want what just happened to happen. Right here, Yusuf misses a terrible shot. They come down, and they get a foul call, and they can bring this. Oh, never mind. It's on the floor. So they can't. They're no free throws. Never mind.
What did you say? You said they had to bring it within 6 before 10?
Yeah, they're in the threshold right now.
You said 5? Yeah, they're there.
They're there in the threshold, but again, we got a minute.
Uh-oh, Donnie. I seen him make it from that corner, and he does again.
I think it's their game plan to make him shoot threes, but he's making them pay.
Yeah, from that corner, he did it last week as well. He made a shot from that corner.
We got a timeout by the Makos.
Oh my, Dom actually told me that he was working with Dom on that shot from that corner.
AJ worked in that corner?
Mm-hmm.
Well, this is the Grooming Gallery, the Orlando's premier barbershop where artistry meets grooming. Horace is a meticulous barber who focuses on providing top-notch cuts, grooming services tailored to your style. Their brand new location's at Hunters Creek, and it's the perfect spot for your next haircut. Actually, pray for Horace because he dislocated his shoulder really bad.
Yeah.
And, yeah, I heard from him. He's at the hospital right now. I think the doctors are taking their time popping into place because they don't want to tear a labrum. But during our game, I want to put that in the pray for the man. I think he's not going to be able to cut haircuts for the next 2 weeks. So
yeah, that's going to be rough.
He's never had an injury like that his entire life. So that's why I think he's going to be out for at least 2 weeks with a dislocated shoulder. I just want to let everybody know.
God damn it. Just when you thought, hey, the Dogs, hey, maybe it's not their year. Oh, the Dogs, they made it a championship. No four-peat for Mike. Down 11 at the half. Guess what? No, they're not. They go on a 16-7 run, cut this lead to 2. Very impressive. Very impressive. Proud of them. They got to keep going. Their defense is caught up. AJ's hit 2 from deep. If they can keep that up. Makos are getting rushed into their shots right now. Once they settle into their offense, I think it'll be different. But, damn, ton of basketball we played. I love you.
It's a tough injury because you do need your shoulder for almost everything in your life.
Thank God I have not done anything to my shoulders.
Shoulders and ankles are the three worst things to hurt yourself.
Yeah, no, that's a really common injury, especially in jiu-jitsu. But thank God I have not gotten hurt doing it. I'm so happy.
Yeah, basketball.
I'd rather take my ankles because I know I can recover from that. And
yeah,
the shoulders.
Oh, good cut.
Wow, that was a great cut. Oh, even better block.
Yeah, great job by, I think that was Brandon Benton. I think that was Spank who blocked that.
Was it really?
I think so.
I thought it was Donnie who came around, but either way, good block for the Dogs. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, what a save.
Spank.
Foul on Kyle.
Oh,
hey.
Spank was it. That was a great pass from Spank, though.
The Dogs now got a chance. They bought it from 11-2 with 10 minutes left. So, I mean, they're doing what they're supposed to be doing. Now, let's see if the Makos can respond in the last half of the half of the season.
When you put it that way, it's a lot riding on here. Oh, my goodness. Goes in for a floater.
Yeah,
Donnie gets
board.
It back. Pass it to Montel. Quick thinking. Spank for 3.
He hit one
Can't
earlier.
Hit.
This Yusuf is where Yusuf's the most dangerous.
Oh,
great defense.
Chef gets it back. Passes it back to Yusuf.
Great defense by Chef. He almost finished the play.
I don't blame Spang for taking that, though. He's wide open from the three. Take a chance.
He hit one earlier, so, I mean, I can't be mad at him. It's not his best suit, but he does – he did hit one earlier, so.
Yeah.
Big shot right here by Youssef.
Oh, man. Splashes it in. Now it's a five-point game.
The Makos are staying in this 2-3 zone. Which, again, what's killing them is rebounding and that right there.
Wow. That's the assist of the day brought to you by We Buy Houses. That was a nice little feed inside.
Yeah, it's just you can't give up the middle in the 2-3. Oh, great take.
Oh, wow. Spank played a little too. He didn't want to pick up the foul.
Yeah, and JPP has a full head of steam, and that's a lot of man right there.
That is. Nice mid-range shot, but he can't connect.
Great take.
And he gets it in.
I like how Parker said that. X did mark the spot because he cut to the right spot for that layup.
Oh, no. Youssef with the steal and the three. Get it.
I know he hit one earlier, but that's not the right time.
And he gets it. It's an and one.
That's a five-point swing right there.
Oh, man.
Yeah, I mean, it was a highlight play. That might be highlight of the season right now.
That's a sweet finish of the day brought to you by Ash's Bake Shop combined with an assist of the day brought to you by We Buy Houses. That was...
Yeah, if we
I
do
wanted
another,
the dunk, but it's all right. He
if we do
the
another
play.
Top 10, that's definitely going to be number one
They
that,
both again, went up for it, and...
He's an athletic freak, man. He's
Montel, man. Wow.
He's Johnny-esque. I got to shout out my boy right there.
I like that. Completes the three-point play.
Crazy thing is, he finished. He's making a lot of free throws, Montel. So you can't foul him. Good hand.
Oh, another steal for the Dogs. Chef going up with it, and he gets it.
Montel has been the X factor of this game. He's been making big plays for them all game long.
A two-point game, 7 minutes left. I think they broke that threshold you were talking about.
They definitely did.
1v1 guy going up and in. And gets an and one. They call it on the floor, it looks like.
No, I think it's an and one.
Oh, it is an and one.
Yeah.
I'm not going to lie, that lane opened up clearly for him to go. There was nothing, no one else.
Went to help.
Yeah, no one else went to help.
Mike gambled from the top, and then no one else helped out Mike. He tried to get the steal. He thought he had it, but no one else had his back on that one, unfortunately. And it rolled around, and it went in. I think that was a prayer that Youssef wanted an answer right there for that free throw. Big shot right here. Oh. Hey, Kyle barely dives on the floor. I appreciate that.
I think he hurt his leg, though, in the process. Youssef pulls a three-point shot. That's
terrible
a brick
shot.
Of the day brought to you by Zane the Realtor. And here comes Donnie McLovin through the legs to the outside.
On the floor right there. Good foul. Calm things down. Waste a couple minutes on the clock. Actually,
talk
a couple seconds off the
pass,
clock.
That passing was that was a good.
This is just great basketball right now. Both teams.
That court awareness that AJ possesses is insane.
So the chef.
Oh wow!
Oh, brick of the day right there by Zane the Realtor. That's a big miss right there.
That's tough.
That was tough.
Sweet finish of the day.
Oh my goodness.
Ash's Bake Shop.
That is why he has a YouTube channel and he calls himself 1v1 God. That was tough. I'll give that to him. And they're back up by 7, just like that.
Donnie gets it in. Gets it done in the paint like he's done all season.
I love the Fadi minutes too, by the way. That's my guy.
Sets good screens.
Opens him up. He should have went for the layup. He had the whole lane. Big shot right here by Kyle. Oh,
big part of this game. And
rebounding has been huge all season for every team.
Oh, yeah. Oh, he couldn't get it in, but he gets the foul instead, keeping this a close one.
But also, this also helps the Makos because we're running a little bit of clock right now. And clock will be a factor in a game like this. I mean, 5 minutes left, clock is still running.
It's crazy. The Dogs always, I think throughout the whole season, depending on the last 5 minutes of a game, we'll see if they can close it out here.
The difference between the beginning of the season for the Dogs and the end is the last 5 minutes, they were losing those games.
Mm-hmm.
And then in the beginning of the season, they lost those games. And in the beginning of the season, the end of the season, they were winning those games.
Oh, yeah.
So it's that's a huge adjustment, and that's on Mike right there.
Maybe one guy. Mike is on him.
Oh, good.
Wraps around. Wow, that's another steal I think he came up with, Chef.
Is one of you one and one?
Oh, yeah, 8 fouls, yeah.
But again, this also is helping the Makos right now, wasting the clock. That's why he stopped it. Stop. Put 4 minutes, 4 minutes, 4 minutes.
Was that a timeout?
Yeah, it was a timeout on Mike. That was smart on him.
All right, well. Oh, it's a close one.
Well, the timeout will be this time. It's going to be on Chris Galco. He was our halftime show.
Mm-hmm.
He did a really good job. He's going to be all over gigs, all over the country. I think he was in Lake Nona the other day. I saw him the other day.
Mm.
Boxy Park, that is my spot. You guys should go there. It's a great spot for family, kids, all that. They got like little food trucks all over the place.
He could sing too.
He definitely could sing.
Yeah, he has some nice vocals.
We've seen him all the time. Me, Ash, the captains. We've seen Chris perform all the time at Howling at the Moon. I mean, he is really good, and I think he has a possibility to make it big. He just got to keep doing what he's doing.
Oh, yeah, the right person has to fall on the right person's ears. And
unfortunately, with like gigs like that, is who you know, not
yeah, really
what
is.
You do. What are you doing? It's do you know the right people?
Exactly.
I think it's almost in anything in life, mainly. It's who you know, not what you know, unfortunately. Big miss. Big rebound by QDZ. Yep.
Missed both free. I feel like they needed those two.
It was a one and one, so he missed the front end. And that's the worst thing to do, is miss the front end of the one and one, because you can't get your second one. But again, this is helping the Makos. They're slowing the game down, taking time away. So they just need to finish the game. I think they've had the lead the whole time.
They have. Oh, Chef gets the steal. Takes it all the way in.
Oh, brick of the day. Montel again. Montel has been the X-Factor.
He's been saving the day. Oh, no!
That's a boneheaded play. I said in the beginning, Yusuf got to keep his composure.
Oh, and then it falls in the hands of AJ. Couldn't make it.
You got to go. You got to go. It's a block. Yeah, that is a good call. He was still moving.
This, oh, my goodness. One-point game. 2 minutes left.
You don't stop the clock. You don't stop the clock.
How many seconds?
But you don't stop it till the last 2 minutes.
I don't know why he's stopping it now.
Yeah, exactly. You don't stop it now. We haven't stopped it all season.
You don't stop it.
It's very emotional right now, both sides,
I mean,
because it is a one-point game.
I think the Dogs need not force anything
here. Big shot right here. Oh, you got to get a rebound if you're the Makos right there. That's a big offensive rebound for the Dogs.
Everyone just stood there looking up to see if it made it or not. Spangus right there, and he gets in!
Again,
Montel
has been the X Factor.
He really
if there's
has.
A finals MVP, I think it goes to Montel.
I mean, he's putting it all out there. He's cleaning up the...
Every single like moment that they need a big play, Montel has done it.
And
Montel,
every time they've missed a shot and needed him to put it back in and clean the mess that they made, he's been there. I mean, wow. That's
Montel definitely has his fingerprints all over this game.
All over, yeah. They can't let him do his thing right here. Good pass. AJ looking for the steal. They're pressing the Makos, not giving them any time to think.
Yusuf really wants it.
He really does, but 1v1 does the correct thing. Slow it down.
Yeah, you take it, take the last shot. Unless it's Kyle right there.
Gets it in! There's still some time left. That was a big shot, though.
Yeah, Chef needs to go take over right here. Yep.
Pass to Spank. Spank. Oh, wow.
A minute left. Now, this is all on Yusuf right now. Yusuf needs to be smart right here. He's been doing boneheaded mistakes all game. Now, if Yusuf wants to be a champion, he can't make a boneheaded mistake. But on Montel's end, Montel has been making everything right for the dog. So if Montel has one big play, it has to be right here.
Yep, dogs are playing.
Yeah, they're letting the clock run. I don't think it's a smart idea.
Call a timeout. They actually stopped the clock.
I don't think that's smart. I would have gave it to Kyle right there because Kyle is the best free throw shooter in the league by far. Other than Santi, I think Santi's the closest from what I saw in the stats. I think Santi's shooting like 90% from the free throw line, but I think Kyle is up there too around the 89 to 91 percentile. I was looking at the stats earlier today.
Do you play the defense? Do you try to force a turnover? Or do you start intentionally fouling? Because right now, you're facing the Makos and the clock. Down two. Shot Doc hit a huge three right here to put the Makos back up by two. 38 seconds left. You have to foul twice at least because they're not in the double bonus or any bonus. So you're going to be wasting a lot of time if you're trying to force a turnover. Let's see what Mike has drawn up now. We're back.
I think Mike should call a timeout if they get the ball and finish the game. But it's all on the it's literally this game is all on the Mako's hands though.
Oh, it is.
Yep. Yeah, they got two more fouls. We got till seven fouls for the 1-1, so they got fouled two more times. I would just do it quick.
Oh!
Oh! Big shot by X.
That might have been the one.
I don't know yet. I mean, it's a 4-point game. I would have held on to it, wasted more time. Oh, that might be game right there.
Yusuf goes up.
That's game.
And that's game. That has to be.
The Makos are champions. They stopped the streak. Great game by both teams, though, by the way.
I agree with you. I think the foul should have came a little bit earlier for the Dogs.
I think the Dogs should have fouled, man.
They would have had a lot more time to work with than this. And the Makos are your champion season 5.
Congratulations.
They broke the Dogs streak first.
Congratulations to the Makos. Great game by the Dogs. This was a great game from start to finish. I just want to shout out Montel this game. He did a really good job. I think his draft stock went up. I think Mike this whole season has done a really good captaining because he started 0-5. Any other captain would have quit. And he went all the way to the championship game and they had a chance. So
I take my hat off to all the Makos team playing team basketball, getting it done. And now they are your season 5 champions. It's got to feel good.
It's got to feel good for Luke. I think it's his second year being a captain. He won one. Congratulations to Luke, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
First, I just want to give a special shout-out to all the teams. You know, everyone fought hard. It was a really good season.
Free Palestine, Makos, baby.
First, I want to shout-out La Familia. It was a really good battle this season, playing them 3 times. Like, I want to ask for another schedule. Like, that's what got us ready for this. Also, I want to thank my teammates.
Get in there. Get in there. Look at this. Go touch the trophy.
Wow, wow. Luke, 50%.
Hey, coach of the year,
50%. You guys dominated the regular season, you dominated the postseason, and now you just defeat the 3-time champion Dogs in very convincing fashion. What do you have to say for yourself, Luke?
I love my team. No trades. We came with how we drafted. I trusted every single one of these guys. For the most part, they trusted each other. It took a little bit for us to get into our groove, but we finally found it. And we can't win a game without making it extremely fucking stressful. I definitely have ulcers, but fuck it. We did it.
Season 5 champions, Luke. Season 5, you deserve it. Enjoy it with your team. Congratulations, my friend. Way to go. Immortalized.
I just want to tell y'all, bro. I told you at the beginning of the season, I'm hungry, bro. So for all y'all who tried me, appreciate you. That was the fuel. Hey, and by the way.
Let's just run it back, man.
Let's do it.
Let's run it back.
Oh. Make us want the run back.
Two-peat. I'm going to try to get a two-peat for next season.
That's what I'm saying.
Let's go.
God, what a hell of a win by an amazing team. Enjoy it. Ladies and gentlemen, that is a wrap on season 5. Makos, our number one. I've been sitting next to Fadi all season. I wouldn't have it any other way. I love you.
He's the real MVP.
You're the real MVP. You guys get a picture. I love you. I'll see you season 6. I love you, Celly Nation.